Hello, welcome. Did you ever notice these infrared ports on older ThinkPads or PDAs? You probably think of them as Stone Age connections, like a serial port or just without a cable. Well, they were better than you remember. Take a look at the facts. Infrared light is invisible to human eyes because of its long wavelength, but a camera can see the infrared. Infrared operates in switching half-duplex mode, so only one direction at a time, because the receiver would be blinded by the light of its own transmitter. The IRDA is the industry group that provides specifications for the protocols, and modern infrared actually goes up to 1 gigabit per second, so let's take a look. ThinkPads support two infrared modes. Older serial infrared was indeed quite slow, with about 15 kilobytes per second. The successor, called Fast Infrared, was already introduced in 1997 with the ThinkPad 380, and it supported 4 megabit per second, amazing for its time, before USB even existed. That is 100 times faster than modem and about the speed of low-end broadband today, so it should be enough to fill a disk in less than 3 seconds. The T60 was the last to have infrared, so faster standards like gigabit were never implemented in ThinkPads. I have here a 600X, a T43P and a T60, all support fast infrared, so let's try a 10 MB file and a 100 MB file transfer. As you can see, devices find themselves automatically, blocks up to 1 meter or 3 feet with about 15 degrees of angle, so you have to aim well. So, speed is 170 kilobyte per second, so less than advocated. Maybe the half-duplex protocol is a reason, so let's send the same 100 megabit file in both directions at the same time. So, then we get 230 kilobyte per second, so still half of the theoretical max speed, so maybe the protocols require that much overhead. Let's try Windows and Linux connected. Does this work? No connection here, but there is probably a setting somewhere activated in Linux as well, but I didn't find it. Okay, let's test if it works through glass. So what if you completely block line of view? Well, it stops and it beeps, but it resumes automatically. Upsides: no risk of boot sector viruses as with USB sticks or account security as with wired networks. No connector also means no cable necessary, so every infrared device could communicate. How about smartphones? This Galaxy S5 has an infrared blaster, so it can only send data. I did try to emulate a TV remote, but nothing happened. So you need special software like Loke, and the setup is quite complicated with limited functionality. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope you learned something old. You can check out my playlist on old ThinkPads as well.